Hello, dear guys. Today we are going to speak about a very important topic on communication strategy and also some tips on how to communicate peace and human rights. And I would like to start my presentation with a discussion about the challenges that we meet on our way of working with communication. We met three groups of challenges. The first one is about the model. If you go through different sources of information about the communication strategy, you will find a lot of examples of different models of communication strategy. And it's very, very easy to get lost in this ocean of information. So within this presentation, I will propose you the model that we developed within our trainings and meetings. We think that it's quite easy one and it's very easy to apply it to your activities. The second group of the challenges that we met was about the some pieces of advice or tips that we can apply to our communities when we communicate peace and human rights. Is it the same to communicate some environmental projects or sport projects and projects aimed on promoting human rights and peace building? Are there any differences? So we will present you some tips that we consider very important. And of course, you can find more information about it. And after this presentation, you will find the forum where you can share your own experience on this, what kind of, let's say, strategies you use for communicating human rights and peace. And the third group of challenges that we met, like what kind of digital tools we can use for making our communication more efficient. We will not speak today about this group of challenges because we're seeing our MOOC every day we learn about digital tools. So I think it's quite enough for you already. And we will be just having focus the first two challenges, the model and the tips. And let's first define what is it communication strategy. So you can read on the screen the definitions that we come up with. And in this definition, the key words are interactive process. So we need to take into account that communication, it's giving information and receiving information. Communication means communicate, to build interaction. And also, if we speak about strategy, it should have very clear strategy, objectives and the results. And why we communicate, why we want to achieve strategic communication at the end, no? Because strategic communication give us involvement of our audience, of our target group, and it helps us to develop relationship between us and our audience. Okay, so now let's jump directly to the communication strategy. As you can see, we compiled all the information to this formula that has three components. The first one is 3P, the second one 2G, and the third one 5W. Let's go through every component of this formula. Okay, 3P, what does it mean? We think that it's very important when we start to plan our communication to think about three main target groups of our project. The first one is our participants, of course, young people who participate in our activities. The second one is our partners. And the third one is projects. Very often we cooperate not just with the organizations, but we communicate and we cooperate with the consortium of partners that represent one project. So when we start to build our communication strategy plan, so let's check the reality and let's check what kind of projects exist in this field. Like for example, for our project Turn Online, we have a cooperation with three projects that are dedicated to the topic of digital transformation, digital tools for young people, for youth organizations. So this cooperation helps us to develop the dissemination, the plan of dissemination plan, and we communicate the results of our partners or other projects, and they do the same. So in this case, we can reach more audience and more people can learn about digital tools for their activities. Sometimes we forget about projects. We just think about organizations, but don't let's also involve different projects to our communication strategy. The third element of the formula is 2G. What does it mean? As I already said, communication strategy and strategical communication and communication in general, it is interaction. Interaction means that we give something and we get something. So when we write any post on our social media, or when we organize kind of conference where we are going to communicate the results, we need to think about these two processes, no? The process of giving and the process of receiving. So what kind of information, resources, support we can give to our audience, and what kind of information, resources, support we can receive from our audience. Just in this case, communication will be efficient one. And then when we know who is our audience, and when we know what we are going to give and what we are going to get, it's very important to plan this communication and to answer of five very important questions that are quite simple ones. What we are going to communicate, where, when, how, and who. And for every action or for every activity within your organizations, you can create kind of plan like now you can see on your screens. So first, when you know your target groups and when you know the collaborative process between you and your target groups, plan what you're going to communicate, what kind of information, resources, links, etc. How, through what kind of, let's say, materials, no, you are going to do it. You are going to record the video, or you're going to develop infographic, or you're going to present some materials, texts. Then where, what kind of social media, or maybe you will organize some events like conferences, like focus groups, no, where you also are going to communicate. Also, when, it's a very important question. No, sometimes we forget about it, and 1 week we communicate and we have a lot of projects on, or we need youth exchange and we are so busy. And we don't communicate at all, so it's very important a regularity of our communication. And who is responsible for it? This is also a very crucial aspect and component of communication, because sometimes, very often, in the youth field, we are a bit chaotic. Why? Because we have a lot of work, we have a lot of projects, and not so many people working for it. And everyone is doing everything. So in this case, if someone doesn't communicate and the other person also forgets about communication. So we don't communicate at all, one week, one day, etc. So it's very important to define the persons who will be in charge of your communication process, your communication strategy in your organizations. So it's quite a simple plan, a simple formula of communication strategy, but it includes all main elements of communication. So use it for your organizations. Maybe you can also add some elements here. We didn't include here evaluation process, like how you're going to evaluate, because I think it's a bit separately process, and afterwards we will see the video that was developed by our colleagues from Bulgaria about Google Analytics. So this is a very good tool to make analysis of your communication, so how you communicate. But if you want to include this component to the communication strategy, to our formula, you are welcome and develop it, use it, share with your colleagues, and improve your communication strategy. Now we are going to speak about some tips on how to communicate peace and human rights. Again, there are a lot of information about it, and there are a lot of pieces of advice. We just propose you five elements, five tips that we consider important ones. And if you apply two or three of them, your communication will be already improved at all. A lot. So, we propose you five tips. The first one is storytelling. Today, you can find a lot of information about it, trainings in the youth field and not in the youth field about how to create good stories. And after this video, you will also find some resource. This is a TED Talk where very well explained the model of good storytelling. And this model includes four components. The story should interest the audience, should instruct, should involve, and should inspire audience. So I will not now explain it, because the video will explain it very, very well. So I really recommend you to watch it. And also, after this video, you will find the story that were developed, that was developed within our training activity, turn online project, where you will find the story of Maria. She is a Greek girl that one day met with her mom some refugees, and this story is really touchable. For our team, for team behind the journal project, it's one of the good examples of storytelling that we would like to share with you. This is a very sincere story, and when Maria is talking, so you, I'm pretty sure that you will have kind of very strong feeling, and the message that Maria sends, it's also quite clear. So also go through this video and try to see in this video these four elements of good storytelling: interest, instruct, involve, and inspire. Then emotional component. I think I already have mentioned it when I was just right now when I spoke about feeling. No? So your communication should give some feeling to people. No? So I think in our youth work and in the work on human rights and peace building, the feeling is very important. So what kind of emotional you would like to share with the audience. Then call for action. So I think it is also already explained in the model of the storytelling. So we need to inspire people to do something. And we can do it with some questions. And you will see that Maria also in her video, she asks you one question at the end of her message. We can do it with proposing people to do something, not to apply for some actions, for giving something, for donate, for supporting some activities. So when you write your post and when you record the video with the message, so try to think what people can do afterwards, after your message. What kind of activities you can propose for them. The next one is that I like a lot, do little things instead of we save the world. Check your informational materials. How often you use such phrases like we will save the world, we will change the world. I think it's a bit enough to use such kind of phrases because a lot of organizations use them. Let's speak about concrete actions, concrete local activities. So what was done? What we are going to do? How we can measure the impact? Let's say about the results. Maybe they are small, but they are real results. They are results of local community. And I think the message of European Commission, of Council of Europe, within their programs, it's quite clear. So go to the people, go to the local realities and do something real. So this tip is actually about this dimension. Do little things and communicate about little things. And the last tip, but not the least one, about the language. So we need to think about what kind of language we use when we communicate human rights and peace. And here I would like to speak about verbs. Now you will see the examples. We're trying to compile this information from different resources. So, and we here want to present you some common used verbs that used by NGOs. Very often we use kind of words like but, no, we have to, we must, we worry, we could. We use the word problem, we will try, our mission. So here you can find not just verbs, but also some, not just verbs, but also some phrases and words. And you can see how you can change, you know, these phrases and verbs for your activities, for your communication, for your text, in order to be more efficient. Instead of to use no, try to use and, try to connect things and not to create some contradictions. Then you can see the difference, no? For example, between must and we have to commitment of, we have the commitment of, or we worry and we care. So we, when we say worry and when we say care, we have different feelings, no? We more inspire people than we send them kind of negative message that can produce some negative emotions. So also my favorite one is we will try and we do. Yeah, so the message is very different when we use we will try to help you and we do, or our intention, not to do it, but not to try, but really to do. Okay? So try to evaluate, try to analyze your texts and your messages that you send to your audience. Try to analyze your language and to change it a bit in order to inspire people, to call them to do something, to call them to go to their small realities, local realities, and to do small things. But really, these things, they help to promote peace and human rights. Well, my presentation is finished, and as I mentioned, that you will find after this presentation other materials on how to communicate peace and human rights, like video TED talk about good storytelling, and also one example. So go through them and try to analyze the information that you received right now. Thank you very much for your attention. And we also wait for your ideas about how to communicate peace and human rights and how you do it in your local realities.